come through this door, people have to go round.
Go around it.
Woo! Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here, y'all gonna make me go all out. Up in here, y'all gonna make me act a fool. Up in here, y'all gonna make me lose my cool. Up in here,
if I got to bring it to you cowards, then it's gonna be quick.
Hi, here we have Kate from TV. The most... You know what? Let's just play the video.
Hello.
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 And welcome to Caterham News.
He's Tom Mason.
And he's Alex Criscarolo. Our first story tonight.
Alcohol abuse.
It's becoming an increasing epidemic at Caterham School, especially among the rugby boys. So we ventured up to the Royal Oak to find out more.
Please turn to our correspondent at the Royal Oak.
Thank you, Alex. We're here outside the Royal Oak Public House in Caterham, an iconic location for some Caterham students. 94.3% of 18-year-old rugby players go out on Saturday night to drink alcohol. Here at Caterham, we're going to show you a different way of how we do it.
Are you doing as usual?
Nah. 6 pints, please.
6 pints?
Of lemonade.
A few moments later.
Thanks, mate.
Cheers, boys. As you can see, us rugby players are setting a good example for Caterham School young students.
5 pints, please, mate. 5 real pints.
Back to the studio. Thanks, Alex. Now for the weather.
From Monday to Friday, we can expect to see overcast skies with a chance of rain. But on
Saturday, things take a turn for the worse, with a 90% chance of showers of poor banter from the Girls' Dance 2K19. This should, however, clear up, with a pressure front of the 3Bs leading to a thunderous applause for the boys.
As we move deeper into the night, we can expect a frosty atmosphere.
She's not real life, she's on the fence.
Oh, mate, she's annoying.
She's f***ing
ten.
You better not be rating girls again, or that's a Saturday.
Right, boys, detention over. You're free to go. I hope you learnt your lesson here, boys.
Yeah, we'll never do it again.
Never again.
Never rating girls. Yeah, but who said we can't rate teachers?
Right, boys, we're here to discuss the senior management team. We'll be rating them out of 10 with a very democratic system, 3-2-1 rate. Our first candidate is Daniel Gabriel. Ready? 3-2-1
4.
Right. Our second assessment will be John Viner. We'll use the same very democratic system. Ready? 3, 2, 1, 2. All of your assessments have been noted. Thank you for all your help today. Meeting adjourned.
I'm a bit unnecessary.
So what happened next, Tom? It's a safe space. You can tell us. I'm on your side.
Well, after the restraining order, she took the kids and
Now there's nothing I can do, and it's just a waste of my time. I can't do it.
It's okay. Better than this.
They're gonna have to go into the Stafford.
Now for our next story. Lifeguarding has been an important role in Caterham School over the years. They've been doing their best to ensure our well-being. Take a look.
Are you in desperate want to help your school community? If the answer is yes, join Caterham School Sports Centre by enrolling to become a lifeguard and joining our elite team of members. Let's see what they're getting up to now. Our lifeguards are extremely caring and are always eager to help out.
Hey, excuse me. I'm new here. Do you know where the toilets are? Excuse me? Do you know where the toilets are?
Don't know, mate.
We are lucky enough to have an exclusive interview with one of our highest trained lifeguards, Charlie Heaton-Armstrong. Hi, Charlie. How does it feel to help your school by giving back to the lifeguarding community?
Well, I mean, it's all right. It helps pay for Saturday nights. It does get a bit boring time to time.
How many hours is the average work shift?
Well, Charlie, do you help me, please? Wait, what are we going to do? Oh, my God!
Wait!
Wait, Charlie.
999?
Thank you, Alex. This concludes our news report for tonight, but tune in tomorrow as we find out about the increasing problem of AirPods at Caterham.
He's been Tom Mason.
And he's been Alex Crisciolo. Thank you for listening. Come to the pub.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So how's that, miss?
Well, William, I'm deeming most of that totally inappropriate. It's all got to be cut, I'm afraid.
Well, that's all we've got.
Tough.